Welcome to this Nomad tutorial. I'm Markus Schaltgen, and in this video I will explain how to publish data on Nomad. Imagine the following scenario. You have performed a couple of calculations that you now want to publish and cite in a paper. We are covering the whole process from the local files on your computer to a citable DOI. Publishing data on Nomad is a five-step process. First, you have to prepare your files, you have to upload your files, you have to review your upload, you have to add additional metadata like co-authors, comments, references, and create citable datasets, and you have to publish your data and create a DOI. Before we start, there are a few things that you need to follow this tutorial. We prepared links to everything in the YouTube description, or you find the information on the tutorial webpage. The first thing you need is a Nomad account. You can use most of Nomad without an account, but if you want to upload data, we need to know who you are. Nomad is hosting all data under the Creative Commons Attribution License, and we need to credit you and your co-authors. Creating an account is easy. You simply go to Nomad and click the Login button. Then you click Register, and then you need to provide your credentials. A username, your name and last name, a valid email address, your affiliation, your affiliation address, and a password. You simply click the button and then you get a confirmation email, and you have to click the link in a confirmation email, and then you have a Nomad account and can log in. The second thing is a set of example files. We prepared a zip file with a few VAS calculations for you, but of course you can also use your own data if you have some available. Here I have the example data on my computer. It's simply a small directory structure with a few VAS calculations in it. While you can upload data to Nomad and delete it again, publishing data and also creating a DOI are permanent operations. For this tutorial, you can use our try and test Nomad. On this Nomad, we are deleting all the data routinely, and all the data is never shown on the official Nomad site. The DOIs that you are getting are not real. Okay, let's start with the first step, preparing your files. Here it is important to understand a little bit how Nomad will see your data. Nomad is different from other data sharing platforms. It does not just host your files as they are. Instead, it will look into your files and parse and analyze its contents. Nomad interprets your data and extracts as much metadata information as possible. Here's an example entry and how it appears on Nomad. First, we see all the metadata, and then we see a list of files that belong to this entry. Nomad distinguishes two types of files, main files and auxiliary files. A main file is usually the main output file of a code run. Each entry in Nomad has exactly one main file and respectively represents exactly one code run. Other files that describe the input of a calculation that might have also been created by the code, or simply files that you created to document your work, will be considered auxiliary files. In this case here, the main file is a VAS run XML. Created by VAS, and all other files like the INCA input file or other outputs like the Eigenval or DOSCA are auxiliary files. After upload, Nomad will look at all your files and it will try to recognize for which of the 40 supported codes each file might be a main file for. If the format of a potential main file was recognized, a Nomad entry is created, and all other files in the same directory are considered auxiliary files to this entry. In other words, all the files here were uploaded in the same directory as the main file. You can also see the full path of the main file here. This gives you an idea what the original upload that contained this calculation looked like. There are several levels of subdirectories, and everything in this subdirectory is displayed here. And this is how you should upload your files. The directory names and how deep they are nested doesn't really matter. In addition to the main output file, please add everything that is relevant to the calculation. Input files, output files, or manually created files are welcome. When in doubt, err on the sides of providing too much data rather than too few data. Ideally, all files that belong to the same code run are put in individual directories. At least only put calculations in the same directory that are closely related. In many cases, you will have done this anyways, and you simply pack up your files and upload them directly to Nomad. When you go to Nomad's upload page, you will get a list of supported codes and further information about how to prepare your files. It will also contain an example file, example command to create a zip file. In principle, Nomad supports zip files and tar files. There are some limits. Uploads should not be larger than 32 gigabytes. If you have more data, please split into smaller uploads. But also avoid to create unnecessarily small files. This will create more work for you and for our servers. We limit the number of unpublished uploads to 10. Okay, we prepared our files, now we need to upload them. The simplest way is to simply use this Dropbox here. You can either drag your file over here, or you simply click the button and select the example file. You will see the upload's progress here. When the file completed upload, the user interface will show you the progress of the processing. This type of upload works very well for small and medium files. In many cases, you might have larger files or files are managed on a remote HPC system. In these cases, you can also use a shell command like curl to upload data. On the upload page, you will find a prepared curl command. This command contains a token that will identify you as the uploader. The token is only used for uploads, but you should still keep it a secret to prevent others from uploading data in your name. You can simply copy the command, go to a shell, use the command and replace the local file with your example file. After the upload is completed, you can go back to the web page and reload. Okay, now I have the same upload twice. I will delete one of these copies. You can simply select the upload and press the delete button. This brings us to the next step, reviewing your uploaded data. Okay, let's click on this upload again and see what we have here. First of all, it tells you how many entries it found in your upload, and then you can see the identified main files, the used parser, and the progress on the processing. You can also click on each individual entry to see the metadata that was extracted. Unavailable metadata. Why is the processing marked as a success when the metadata is unavailable? Normal tries to be very liberal with errors, because we don't want processing errors to keep you from publishing your data. In many cases, NOMED parsers and normalizers have to work with incomplete information and errors are hard to avoid. In any case, as long as a NOMED was able to identify a main file, you can still publish the entry. When NOMED's processing improves over time, we routinely reprocess all data, and processing with failures or unavailable metadata might succeed in the future. If you uploaded a lot of data, it might be very tedious to manually click through all the entries. You can also go to the Your Data page. Here you see NOMED's search interface applied to only your entries. And you can use the search visualization to get an overview about the metadata of your uploads. If you are not satisfied with your upload, you can delete an upload again and re-upload corrected data. As long as an upload is not published, it can be deleted again. And also, as long as an upload is not published, it will also not be visible to others than you. Let's say we completed our upload and want to continue. The next step would be to add additional user metadata. If you look at an example entry, you will see the extracted metadata over here and the user metadata below here. The user metadata is not determined by the processing, but is determined by you. You can provide additional comments to your calculations, additional references, like to your paper, for example, additional co-authors, and you can also create datasets. To edit your entries, you have several options. The simplest thing is that you simply go to your upload, select all the entries, and press the edit button. This will give you an edit dialog. Let's go through some of the options. You can add an arbitrary text as comment, you can add references, you can add co-authors, you can share your data, and you can create datasets. Comments and references are kind of self-explanatory. To add co-authors, you can try and find them in NOMED by entering their names. If your co-author does not have a NOMED account yet, you can create one here. Your colleague will get invited and you can use her as a co-author even before she confirmed her email. We require all uploaders to truthfully name their co-authors as per our terms and general good scientific practice. Please do not invite any fake or test users. In the same manner, you can share data. The share data feature will allow the named people to see your data, even if it's not published or if it is published with an embargo. We will hear later about embargoes. To assign data to a dataset, simply give a name for your dataset. If it does not exist, it will be created. Choose your names carefully and explicit. This will be used to represent your data on NOMED. Names can be long and they can contain spaces. Each entry can be assigned to many datasets. This allows you to create nested hierarchies of datasets. You can think of datasets like albums on an image sharing platform. Let's submit now. If you look at our entries, we should now see the metadata that we added. You can see all your datasets on the Your Data page. This is the dataset that we just created. If you look into the dataset, Nomad will use the search interface again to represent the dataset. This is like the regular search, but now we only see all the entries in the dataset. This is also how others will see your dataset. Datasets have URLs that you can copy and send around even before you have a DOI. Okay, this brings us to the final step, publishing your data. Simply go back to the upload page, select your upload, and press the publish button. Now you can either publish right away or you can select an embargo. Let's talk about embargoes for a second. Nomad allows to use embargoes for up to 3 years. You can later lift embargoes at any time with the edit dialog. The idea is that you can already publish data before paper publication to give reviewers a chance to see your data. The metadata of embargoed data becomes public so that reviewers can see what your data is about, but no file contents, archive data, or other details can be accessed unless explicitly shared. After 3 years, we might automatically lift the embargo. Otherwise, you can edit your data and lift the embargo there. Nomad is a platform for data sharing, and in general, we encourage you to be as open as possible. Only use the embargo function if necessary. I will now go ahead and simply publish the upload without embargo. Now the data is published and can be seen by everybody. After you publish the data, you cannot delete the upload anymore, but you can still edit the user metadata and of course lift an embargo. Once you publish without an embargo, you cannot create an embargo anymore. For published datasets, you can create a DOI. Once a DOI is created, you cannot remove data from the dataset anymore. Only new entries can be added, for example, to publish corrections to prior calculations provided. To assign a DOI, simply go to the list of datasets on the Your Data page and click the DOI action. Answer the Confirm dialog and your dataset will now have a DOI. DOIs will resolve to the dataset page that shows the respective dataset. This concludes our tutorial. Again, you will find links, examples and instructions on the tutorial webpage or in the description. You can use the test Nomad to type publishing and creating DOIs. Otherwise, you can also use the official Nomad, as you can delete uploads again before you published. There are other tutorials in the series about the search interface, about the API, and about how to process data locally. Thank you for using Nomad.